Hello people and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Deep Roy Choudhury and I'm just a normal guy who talks about stuff that seems interesting and important to me. And today I'm going to talk about the fact that I'm pretty sure that a huge chunk of people, maybe in the millions, maybe in the thousands, a huge number of content creators, or not just content creators, a huge number of people around the world might be in the business of buying and selling fake views, fake subscribers, fake hits, fake likes, fake comments, all these kinds of stuff, fake retweets. And I would say these people collectively are literally killing, or actually maybe not killing, but they are drastically impacting the business model of YouTube, Facebook, all these platforms that are out there. I mean, think about this, just for a second think about this. Why would advertisers would bother to invest in these platforms, would bother to advertise their products on these platforms when these metrics would lose their value, when people would not even believe these metrics? Because one Indian rapper apparently, paid 7.2 million Indian rupees for 72 million views. So and his video got 75 million views in one day. So 72 million of those 75 million were paid views. How can we even trust anyone? And I'm pretty sure that and that rapper is saying that, you know what, I actually advertised my video on YouTube through YouTube's official advertising platform, I guess. But even that is feels unfair to me, because if your video is running in the form of an ad in the middle of someone else's video, and that ad view when your video is running as an advertisement on someone else's video, and that advertisement, that viewing of that advertisement somewhere else is now counting as a view, and that's how, if most of those 72 million paid views were occurring, people are just going to lose faith in the entire system all along. I mean, why even bother with having the view counter in the first place? Why bother with views, likes, hits? You know, there's no need for a counter anymore. I mean, if this is what people are going to do, if this is what, you know, the system has to change, in my opinion. I mean, if all these hits, millions of views, millions of likes, millions of comments, all of these can be manufactured by paying some PR agency or whatever agency that might be, and these agencies are legal, mind you, because they have technically there is no law that prohibits the buying and selling of fake views, subscribers, and all these kinds of activities. Technically, these are legal, but I mean, what can we do? I mean, that would basically mean the whole thing about metrics and views and all these stuff would just lose significance. And think about that. Think about what is happening to Badshah and right now, that Indian rapper who has been accused of buying views. That rapper's reputation is in shambles. Because of the 75 million views that he got on day one, I don't know what is the view count on that video right now, but within one day he got 75 million views on that video, and that out of those 75 million views, 72 million are paid views. So what that means, there were only 3 million organic views on that day, and then he was claiming that his video became the world's most viewed. Became the video with the most number of views within one day. That's what he was claiming. That's what his PR agencies were claiming, I think. So what's the point of all this? Now his reputation is in shambles. Now people would think twice before paying him an astronomical amount of money for any live show. I'm pretty sure that that must have been some his objective from the start. He thought that, you know what, I can spend this much amount of money on advertising. Maybe he did it through a legal thing. Maybe through he used YouTube's own advertising platform for that. I am going to give him the benefit of the doubt, give him the benefit of doubt for now. But even if he got most of his views on that video through his through YouTube's official advertising platform or advertising agency, whatever that might be, but the fact of the matter is he paid for those views, or maybe his music label paid for those views. Maybe I should not blame him, because music labels are also take a lot of decisions, but I do not know. Maybe it was him, maybe it was music label, maybe it was both. But at the end of the day, the views were paid, the paid views, and now any person, any event manager or anyone who is basically inviting Badshah for any live show, or inviting any musician for a live show, would think twice as to, does this person in front of me actually have these many views, or has he just paid for getting all those views? Does his so-called popularity on social media, is it real, is it organic, or is it just fake bots just liking his view, liking his comments, liking his social media profiles, ushering in millions of hits on his Instagram content? So is the engagement that you see on the on his videos, on his videos on YouTube, on his videos on Facebook, Instagram, wherever that might be, are those fake? That's the first question that any event, anyone who is inviting Badshah or any musician for a live show, that person would ask. Why would I pay him this astronomical amount of money? How do I know that this person actually gets the millions of views that are organic? Isn't that a valid question? More on this in the next video, I think. Until then, please consider liking this video, please consider sharing this video with your friends and acquaintances, and please consider subscribing to my channel. That would help me a lot. Until the next video, stay safe, goodbye, and God bless you.